Hello everyone, today we're going to be creating this jellyfish in Adobe After Effects using Trapcode Form and Trapcode Mir. So if you're interested in this tutorial, please keep watching. So we're going to start by creating a new composition. And I'm just going to name this jellyfish. And this is going to be a 1920 by 1080 composition, and we are going to make the duration 3 seconds. Next, we're going to add our background layer. So we're going to go to Layer, New, Solid. And I'm just going to name this background. And we'll keep all the settings the same. And now we're ready to start our jellyfish. So go to Layer, New, Solid. And this will be our jellyfish base. And we'll be using Trapcode Form for this part of the jellyfish. So now we'll go into Under Effect. And trap code, and then trap code form. And then we're going to go into the designer tab. And under presets, under basics, we're going to pick the basic fractal sphere. And then I'm going to go to, under base form type, I'm going to choose OBJ model and then choose OBJ. And we're going to be using the hemisphere for this. And click OK. Now I'm going to choose the XYZ individual and resize the X to 640. Y to 470. Under particle type, I'm going to choose the glow sphere. And then under color, I'll just pick this turquoise color and click apply. Now go to Layer, New, Solid. And this is going to be our jellyfish arms layer, and we're going to be using Trapcode Mir for this. So go to Effect, Trapcode Mir. And now I'm just going to change some of the settings here, position Z. I'm going to change to 10. Rotate X to 176. Rotate Y to 43. Size X, I'll bring down to 60. And size wide, I'll bring up to 550. And now under my jellyfish arms layer, I'm going to bring down the opacity. And now I'm just going to resize it, scale it down. And now under fractal with the time ruler at the beginning, we're going to animate the jellyfish arm. So click the stopwatch on scroll Y, and then drag the time ruler all the way to the end of the frame, and enter 100. Okay, now I'm going to duplicate, so I'm just going to hit Command D to duplicate each layer. And now I'm just going to reposition this. Okay, now we're going to go to Layer, New, Solid, and this is going to be our tentacles layer. And now go to Effect. Trapcode form. And under the designer tab, we're going to go under presets. And under lines, we're going to select massive strings. And now I'm just going to change some of the settings, the XYZ settings. And now under color, I'm just going to set my color. Now I'm just going to position everything where I want it. So now we're going to pre-compose our jellyfish. So just command select all the jellyfish components and then right click and hit pre-compose. And we're just going to name this jellyfish. So now everything's connected. All the jellyfish elements that we created are connected now. And now I'm just going to add a glow. And I'll bring the glow threshold up to 75. And now I'm just going to resize the jellyfish. And I'm just going to rotate it. So now I'm going to go to layer new and create an adjustment layer. And now we're going to go under effects and presets and enter mesh warp. And I'm going to drag that into my adjustment layer. And then I'm just going to add some more rows and columns. So before we start the mesh warp, we're going to animate our jellyfish. So under the jellyfish layer, we're going to go under transform. And just make sure your time ruler is at the beginning, and you're going to click the stopwatch for anchor point and just drag the time ruler all the way to the end. And then we're going to enter 2000 for the end point. Okay, so now we're going to add our mesh warp. So under the adjustment layer, click on the mesh warp. And I'm just going to push in each corner as the jellyfish moves along in the frame. Now I'm going to pre-compose my adjustment layer, my jellyfish layer. So just hit right click and hit pre-compose.